Hello friends, I'm Paul Shinn. This is the Boomerist Car Channel on YouTube. Today we're going to be talking about Ford Model A ammeters, or for short, ammeters. And specifically, how to take a reproduction ammeter and make it to where it's not a fire hazard. Welcome back to my shop, where safety is the highest priority. If you've ever had the opportunity to fondle an original Ford ammeter, you are one of the lucky few. You will notice some major differences between the original and the aftermarket new repro. Number one, the size of the electrical terminals themselves. These are metric, these are obviously not metric, and these are a little larger. The ammeter itself, obviously, these are built with amazing quality. If you look inside an original ammeter, and you see how the insides are built. Amazing. It's got this little horseshoe magnet kind of around the top outside. The parts are just made with real quality. Whereas you look at the new reproduction ammeters, and these just say cheap everywhere. So these are still calibratable, but not very easily. The biggest problem is these pose a fire hazard in your Model A, and I'm going to talk about that in a few minutes. But we're going to talk about a couple things, eh? So through the years, the reproduction ammeters, they went from the originals to the reproductions that were made in the 50s, and these were still made pretty much the same internally, more or less. The next reproductions, these were made in the 70s, and these are okay. Then they went to these, which you could get in the 80s. I can't even get this one apart. And these are just really cheap. I don't know what it is, tin or something, or I don't know. But anyway, these aren't all that bad. But the ones they're making now, these are absolutely horrendous. So the biggest problem with these is that they generate their own heat because these terminals, which are just a screw here put in through these connections, these made out of brass, those don't make very good contact after a while. They build up resistance, and as you know, electrical current flowing through resistors makes heat. These get hot, and if there's enough resistance, they get hot enough, these will burn up. So that has happened on a few Model A's, which is why I'm going to make this video today to show you how to fix these so that they won't start a fire in your Model A. It won't be quite as good as an original ammeter, but it'll be a whole lot better. The trick to lowering the heat this produces is to lower the resistance through it. So right out of the box, let's check the resistance on this thing. Look at that. Let's call it 0.28 ohms. 0.28 ohms. That's a quarter of an ohm resistance through this. That will build up some heat over time, especially as more amps are being drawn. Now, once the battery's at full charge, and let's say you're using an alternator or your generator is set with the third brush, only putting out a couple of amps, that'll probably work just fine. But eventually you're going to be running headlights, you're going to be putting a huge charge current through it or something, and that thing's going to build up a lot of heat. So I'm going to show you how to make this cheapy reproduction ammeter safer and make it look better. I'm going to start by lowering the resistance through this ammeter by soldering these brass round head screws to these brass strips that go through the ammeter. Now, you got to be really careful. You don't want to put too much heat on this for too long because you'll just melt these little plastic insulators right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my professional auto temp iron here, turned it up to 1,000 degrees. If you have a 100 watt Weller soldering gun or something, that'd work. If you have a little 25 watt Radio Shack soldering iron, that's not going to work. You won't get enough heat on this fast enough. So you got to get heat fast and hot. And then first thing I'm going to do, though, before I do that, is I'm going to scratch up the brass, not only the top of that screw, but also the strip right where they meet with my greenie screwdriver. Anybody who's been in electronics knows exactly what a greenie is. If you don't, that's a greenie. So now that I've got that good and scratched up, now I'm going to get some heat on this using 60-40 solder. So that means it's 60% tin, 40% lead with a rosin core. Do not use acid core solder. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the heat on this fast and flow some of this in between and just get this connection hot enough to get this to flow and make that electrical connection between the brass strip and the head of that brass screw. And that's it. Stop. Well, I'll make that a little prettier. There we go. Okay. Do the other one. Get it hot. Get it to flow. All right, now let that cool down real good so that we don't melt anything. Hopefully we haven't melted the little plastic insulators. To find that out after it cools off, see if you can tighten these. If you can, you probably melted that little bit. But as long as there's enough material there, you're fine. Don't worry about it. So let's check the resistance now. The first thing I want to check is make sure that there's no shorts between the terminals and the case of the ammeter. So I'll just measure across. Excellent. That is wide open. So that means that we haven't melted any of these down to the point where any of these are making contact with the case. Now let's measure the resistance between the terminals. There we go. How about 0.0006 ohms? That is a drastic improvement from 0.25 ohms resistance through this ammeter. That is not going to build up any heat at all, and that was just from soldering those brass screws to those brass strips inside the ammeter. So there's improvement number one. Now we're going to improve the looks of this thing greatly. According to the judging standards, the inside of the ammeter should be a satin black, so I'm going to do that. I'm going to get some lacquer thinner and some cotton swabs, and I'm going to prepare the inside of this ammeter to receive a light coat of satin black paint. Luckily, most of the inside of the ammeter isn't really seen through that little tiny window in the glass. Really, what we got to worry about is the parts that you can see, so I'm not going to worry about the bottom part of this. Now, you can ruin one of these by getting paint in the mechanism here, so try to avoid that. I'm going to show you what I'm going to do to mask that off. Get some easily removable blue tape. The first thing I'm going to do is tape around the outside of the ammeter because I don't want to build up any kind of paint on this and make it more difficult to get the bezel and everything back on. So just go all the way around the outside like so. Now the fun part. Okay, get all this here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut and make sure to get plenty of finger oil on this. I don't want it too sticky. In fact, you just put it on your rag and get it to where it's not sticky. Okay, now I'm just going to cut a strip of this. About so wide. This is the touchy part. Don't put it on the needle itself. Just put it on the edge of the ammeter like that and just kind of touch. That's it. That's all you got to do. That's plenty of masking for the really light coat of paint we're going to put on this thing now. Cheapy hardware store primer works great for this. I'm just going to mist a couple of light coats on there as I spray myself. That's it. That's all you want to do. Let this dry. Take the tape off. See how it looks.
Eventually.
After the paint's thoroughly dry, now's the time to unmask and see how you did. There we go. Not too shabby. Now, as soon as we put the cover on this thing, it should look an awful lot like the original one. Now, if you look really close in there, you'll see little tabs on either side of where the needle is. That is the parts you bend so that you can calibrate this to get it centered or to get the current to read correctly. I don't really worry about that too much. I just want to see if I'm charging or discharging, so I pretty much leave those alone. So once this thing is set, now we can put the cover back on, make sure that this is centered correctly so that the meter is right dead center. Carefully push the bezel back on. Still make sure we're centered. All right, with the bezel all the way down, there she is. It's awful hard to tell the original from a reproduction after you do those little modifications there. Not too shabby, huh? So, okay, maybe it's not full points if the judges are really picky, but if the judges aren't super picky, that's full points right there. You can hardly tell the difference. Look at that. Not bad, huh? And this one isn't going to build up a bunch of heat and catch fire now because there's no resistance through the ammeter, and it's going to be a lot safer. So hopefully that helps you get and keep your Model A on the road, and you'll do so safely by not having an ammeter burn up on you. It's a real discerning thing to have smoke coming out of your dash panel right behind your gas tank when you're driving your Model A. I've had it happen. It sucks. You don't want that. So modifications like this help keep you safe. Now, if you can find a reproduction ammeter that has 20-0-20 on it, get it. Unfortunately, if you look at the catalogs now, the ammeters available say 30-0-30, and you don't want one that goes from 30 to 30 because the originals said 20-0-20. So get you a reproduction that says 20-0-20 on it. Now, does that mean you can't run more amps through it? No, of course not. A lot of people, they put halogen headlights or something, and you say, well, 20 amps isn't enough. I need to put a 30-0-30 in there so I can see. No, you don't. Especially after this modification's been done and there's no internal resistance, you could run 50 amps through this thing. It'll just peg out at 20 and stay there. it won't really hurt anything. But you could draw 50 amps through this thing, no problem now. So it doesn't really need a 30-30 alt. You just don't need it. So get you a nice 20-0-20. You might find it at a swap meet. Maybe some of the reproductions will start making these again. I don't know. But for now, I guess all you can get is 30-0-30. So you can find one of these at a swap meet or at your buddy's house. Grab it. Hang on to it. Thank you so much for watching. There are lots more videos like this coming up. I'll catch you on the next one. Make sure to subscribe. Click the subscribe right down there.